Hello, hello, my name is Bullsaye, and I'm quickly going to show you what Discord is and how to use it. So let's get into it. Discord is kind of a mashup of Skype, TeamSpeak, and IRC. And what I mean by that, I'll show you in a bit. Part of it is that you don't add individuals, instead you join a server similar to TeamSpeak and Mumble. But you can and should create an account. To join a server, you need to be sent an invite link or find one on a website, etc. Quite a few gaming communities and streamers have started using Discord for this. Once you click such a link, it will open a new tab in your browser. It will ask you to choose a username, if you don't have one already, that is, and hit continue. Otherwise, there's just going to be an accept invite button. After that, you will find yourself on the server that you've been invited to, using the web client. The first thing you want to do now is go into the user settings and confirm your account by entering an email and a password. Now you can close the tab and go to your emails to confirm your account. What I'd suggest you do now is go and download the desktop client for your operating system. At the time of recording this, there's no native Linux client yet, but that should change in the future. The link to the download page is now on screen and also in the description. Now let's have a look at the interface. Over here on the left side are all the servers that you're part of. You can switch between them by clicking on the appropriate icon. You can also create your own server by hitting the plus symbol at the end of the server list. But I'm not going to go into how to set up a server in this tutorial. Then over here are all the text channels and below that the voice channels. Join one by clicking on a name. One of the differences to Skype and TeamSpeak is that there are, or at least can be, multiple text and voice channels that aren't connected in any way. And by that I mean that you can be in one voice channel talking to one buddy and at the same time be texting in any of the other text channels with another. To leave a voice channel, you want to hit the disconnect button down here next to the connection info. Right below that are the buttons for muting and deafen yourself and also the user settings. But we will get back to those. Over to the right, we have a fairly self-explanatory chat section. A thing or two I want to mention is that you can upload images with either this button, drag and drop, and also, what most people probably won't know, CTRL and V if you have an image in your clipboard. Very useful for screenshots. You can also mention people using @and the username. That will trigger a push notification on their side. Keep in mind that you may not be able to chat, mention, or even be able to look at certain channels. That is completely up to the server owner. The last thing on the right side is the user list. It will show you who's online and what they're playing, and who isn't. It is also a good place to message people, by clicking on their name and hitting the message button. But that works everywhere where you can see a username. If you want to check in with your private messages, you can do so in the top left corner. The newest conversations are going to be on top. You can also use this nifty search feature if you're looking for a specific message. You can also use it to start a new conversation with anyone you share a server with. Now it's time we look at the user settings. I'm not going to go into everything though. On the account tab, you can change your avatar image, your username, and if need be, your password. Under the voice tab, you can set your microphone and headphones. It's also where you switch between voice activity and push to talk. If you choose the latter, Discord will ask you to set a push-to-talk key. The keybinds tab allows you to create keybinds, for example for muting yourself or a push-to-mute key. In appearance, I'd suggest using the dark theme, but of course that's up to personal taste. The games tab allows you to disable the in-game overlay for a specific game, in addition to the aforementioned currently playing feature. In the overlay tab, you can enable the overlay and set a toggle keybind, as well as change a few settings. The local tab allows you to change the UI language. Lastly, I just want to mention a few things that aren't readily apparent. If you want to log out of Discord completely for some reason, maybe because you're using multiple accounts or want to set up a bot, you can do so from within every tab in the user settings by hitting this icon twice. And if you want to exit out of the application completely, which hitting the X icon in the top right corner does not accomplish, you'll need to come down here to the taskbar and look for the Discord icon. You may need to hit the up arrow to find it. Once found, right-click it and hit Quit Discord. This is also where you take Discord out of the system startup. If there is a new update for Discord, you will see a green icon in the top right corner next to the minimize icon. Lastly, I feel the need to mention that Discord is still a work in progress tool and things might change and new features will be added. And that for obvious reasons I could not go over those in this tutorial. I also didn't cover everything there is to keep it short and simple. That being said, I can only hope that you learn a thing or two, and if you want to know anything else, like how to set up a server with permissions and roles, or how to add bots to your server, let me know. For now, I'm just gonna say bye bye.